I read in an interview that you did not long ago, I can't remember the magazine, that you were a little bit hesitant about releasing From the Horse's Mouth because it was so personal.
A little bit at first, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Just because of that. It's really one of my favorite pieces, but it was just so personal, the whole experience of writing it.
Mm-hmm.
And everything. I kind of felt the same way when I released Every King a Bastard Son. It was, you know.
Yeah.
Those are like the most personal, introspective looks at myself. So it's kind of weird when you're like, oh, well, other people are going to hear that too.
Was it a good healing method?
Oh, yeah, it was, actually. I think it's about the only thing that really saved me at that point was sitting down and writing out this stuff.
Well, the last time that we spoke, we had spoken a lot with about a lot of the projects that you've been involved with over the years, and well, this time around, I'd like to touch on maybe, you know, like Roz as a person, you know, who Roz is, the man behind the music,
okay,
if you will. because I've followed you throughout the years, and, you know, it's just, I kind of want to get a look at the man behind the music, and, I don't know, a question that I have here is, how old were you when the thoughts of man's mortality became a question? And how did this affect, what effect did this have on your life?
I would say pretty early on, since I was raised in a very religious home, those ideas were, you know, pretty much around from birth, although I didn't, you know, pay them much attention until
mm-hmm.
maybe around 9 or 10 or something, and
mm-hmm.
which is, you know, the same time when I discovered that it was music that I wanted to be doing with my life.
Right.
Affecting me, it was, as I told people before, the writing of the first album was basically a reaction to what I was hearing from my parents and so forth, things that I didn't really like
mm-hmm.
what I was hearing when I was hearing them. And I was kind of like, you know, I thought some things were put in the wrong way, and you know, it was kind of like this fear factor, you know, playing a role, and so the first album was kind of written in reaction to that, and exercising some of that out of myself, you know.
Right. Through a lot of your work, you seem to exhibit the darker side of things. Growing up, were your childhood fascinations fixed more on the morbose?
I don't know if I'd say any more so than anybody growing up. But,
uh-huh.
I mean, you know, I wasn't like fascinated by anything really growing up besides music. Which isn't in itself too dark or morbid, but, you know, of course, as I said, you know, I thought about other things because of the religious aspect and certain things that were told to me at the time, and how, you know, dreams, which I find very important to waking life, you know, at the time were considered to be of the devil, and,
mm-hmm.
and you know, well, of course I dreamt, so
yeah.
I was like, oh, the devil must be in there somewhere under my bed, or in my head, or something. And so, you know, I mean, those thoughts would arise, but, you know, I never really dwelled on anything. It's just what next record I was going to buy.
Yeah. Would you consider yourself a paranoid human being?
At times, definitely. Not most of the time.
Really?
But, I mean, there are certainly times when I become a bit paranoid and
mm-hmm.
a bit agoraphobic. And,
When I have a lot of people say to me, you know, I bet you he carries a handgun.
I'd be afraid to own a handgun, put it that way.
Knock too many people off.
Yeah, or myself, or, you know, probably by accident, which would just be absolutely ridiculous, I don't know, I deal with things okay, kind of involved in my own world, so it's when I have to be a part of the so-called real world, it's just, I don't know, you know, I'm kind of like, put myself somewhere different.
Yeah. Is there a particular item or something, I mean, that you endeared most as a child, like a particular item, whether it be, you know, something given to you or...
Not really, no. I mean, I've always been one to collect things and a bit of a pack rat in that. you know, like I said, mostly when I was a child, it was, you know, my fascination was just collecting records and, and music, and I did have a skull collection for a while when I was younger, you know, just like little plaster skulls. Ones. I remember my mother telling me I had to put them away once my grandmother was coming over.
Were you the kind of child that would go out and join in with the other children in the neighborhood? And
not really.
You're more secluded.
I think in elementary school I was a bit more attentive to other people around me. Then as I kind of got to the end of elementary and like junior high and stuff, I was just kind of more of a loner.
Would you say that you were, as a child, would you say that you were the bully or the bullier?
I was not a bully, no. No. In fact, at one point in high school, I had to get myself a bodyguard. Well, actually, he offered to be my bodyguard.
Oh, really?
I was like, okay. You know, Mr. Mechanics class woodshop guy. Love your bodyguard. It's like, okay.
Did you ever just, like, snap out on somebody and completely surprise them, you know?
Oh, yeah. Just... I mean, sometimes you have to. I would normally just, you know, even with my life today, it's like, you know, I normally just try to ignore situations where, you know, people are just being idiots because I feel like, well, you know, there's no reason for me to get on that same level with them. But, but then again, you know, there's a point where people can push too far and then, you know, something has to be done.
Were you a good student in high school or did you not really care about school too much?
No, basically the only reasons I went to school were to, like, meet up with a couple of friends and then ditch school for the day. Didn't really care much for what they had to talk to me about.
Were you fond of music class?
I've never taken any music classes.
Really?
No. I liked my art class for a while, but that was, like, really the only thing. I wanted to take driver's education just to see the films, but I never ended up taking it. But now they're on video, so I guess I didn't miss it.
I know that you have a fascination for serial killers.
I have an interest.
An interest.
It's a fascination, but an interest, yeah.
Okay, I have a question for you. I don't even know if you've ever thought of before, so I don't know how you'll be able to answer this. But hypothetically speaking, if you were a serial killer, what would your trademark be, and who would your targets be?
That might be a little more information than I need to give I was actually thinking about this a few days ago.
Oh, really?
I was talking to some friends, and it's kind of interesting because, you know, I read a lot about, I mean, various different killers and stuff, but mostly my main thing is men who kill other men or boys.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that, I mean, if I were to do something, it would be the same. It would either be a man or a boy that I would kill,
uh-huh.
Men or boys. I don't know why, though. I mean, you know, I mean, being gay, it's kind of weird. But I don't know. I just think if I killed a woman, it would just be out of pure anger and
uh-huh.
frustration. But killing a man would, I know this sounds bizarre, but kind of be more out of an act of love in a way.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. But I don't know if I would have any particular, like, style or MO, you know.
Uh-huh.
Sure. I'd probably want to leave something behind.
Uh-huh.
Like, you know, just some kind of identifying mark, but I'm not quite sure what that would be. And if I decide 2 years from now to actually start doing it, if I told you, I'd blow it right there.
Do you find yourself frequently fighting the dark angel on your shoulder, who is edging or perhaps egging you on and tempting you to do things that you would wish to refrain from?
There are occasions, yeah, but it's not, I don't know, it's not really something that is like an overpowering thing,
mm-hmm.
you know, it's just something that I realize is there and that, you know, just like anything else needs to be dealt with, you know,
mm-hmm.
at certain times it'll be like, hey, you know,
yeah.
remember me? You gotta do something. Like, okay. You know, but I try to work those things out in a more positive way than I used to.